Today is the long-awaited or very much promised makeup routine. I keep calling it a makeup like tutorial, but I can't show you how I do my makeup. I really can't. As y'all can tell, the girl's got her hair done. Only thing that I'm missing, really, my edges are shiny because I just did them. Please don't say a word. But the only thing that's missing is like curls throughout, like the braids kind of falling down and being in my face, but I left them at school, so it's either I buy new ones or I wait until I go back to school. So right now I'm just rocking it in a bun by itself. Normally it'll be in a bun and it, yeah, whatever. I filmed this video previously and I liked it. It was a good like video makeup wise, but like content and like me talking wise, I really wasn't talking about nothing. It was really, it's like mid video. So, and like the setup was wrong, the lighting was bad. So I'm retrying again with this one. And it's gonna be more of like a chit chat, girl talk, advice mixed with makeup. So yeah, I already did my like skincare. I always do that first, like before I even like put on clothes or before I even like put on lotion and stuff on my body. I always do my skincare first. It is like very important and I've been breaking out, so I've been really trying to prioritize that. But let's just get in. If I don't say the product, I'll put a picture in what the product is and how much it is. That's why I'm low-key kind of like to the side a little bit, because this is where everything is gonna happen. Anyways, so let's talk. I'm gonna use going with the milk first. I'm more of an e.l.f., the pink e.l.f. primer girl, but I ran out and my mom had this just sitting in her room, so I took it. My mirror is right there, so if you see me look right here, it's because my mirror is right here. I should probably, because the lighting coming from both sides. Okay, I'm not gonna move it. Whatever. So this is my last week home before I go back to school, and to say I'm excited for school is an understatement. Really, I am so excited to go back, because something about me that a lot of people don't know is I love school. I love learning new things. I love reading. Like, that's just me. I love reading. I love learning new things. And I may not be the best at every single subject, but I don't need to be the best in order to love learning. And that's like a stereotype people really need to get rid of. Ooh, I'm like short of breath. It's just one that they really need to like get rid of, basically, because I love school with literally all my heart and I'm so excited. I'm also just excited for the next upcoming semester, like dance wise this is like where it all counts. Like, this is when comps are happening, this is when showcases are happening. Like, this is where it all counts and I'm just so excited. I go with the e.l.f. poreless putty primer under my eyes to help with my creasing a little bit. So yeah, but I'm just super duper duper duper, my makeup bag is causing all this fucking slime, so sorry. Let me fix this. Where's my bag? Yeah, I'm just excited overall, because this is really about to be my semester. I also just love my friends and my roommate. Like, I just love, my roommate is like my best friend when it comes to school. I'm just excited to continue to experience the college experience with them, because genuinely, if I didn't have these friends, like if I weren't friends with the people that I'm friends with, I don't think I'd have a good time. Not with my mama, but I'm just, like, if I weren't friends with those people, I don't think college would be my cup of tea. Because I can spend time alone. I feel like definitely this month and a half break that I have from school, I realized that I do love my own company. I love going out on solo dates. I love just running errands by myself. Like, I used to think that when I was like back even my junior senior year of high school, I genuinely thought that I would need to be with people 24/7 in order to enjoy my time. Like, if I was by myself, I was gonna be bored. If I was by myself, I was gonna be miserable. And yeah, obviously, like, there's some instances where you're by yourself and you're just like, damn, I really wish like I could talk to somebody right now, or I could do something with somebody right now. But I thought it would be like that for me 24/7 if I was by myself. But definitely, I think towards the end of my senior year and that summer before my senior year, I realized that like I'm me. Like, of course I'm gonna enjoy my own company. Like, I'm Beayana. Like, and so I thought going into college I wasn't gonna meet the right people for me, because genuinely I was still trying to find myself. So I thought I wasn't gonna find the right people. And at first, the people I was hanging out with, you know, I don't want to say they weren't the right people, they just, our lives just didn't align with each other, and like our personalities didn't align with each other. Like, they were good people, they were good friends, and I genuinely sincerely wish them the best, and I honestly still love them too. Like, if we were to ever talk, some of them, if they were to come back into my life and be like, can we be friends, I'd be like, hell yeah, we can be friends. But anyways, I feel like I made my solid group of people, and I'm just excited to go see them. I'm excited to endeavor in this new, because everybody's like, each semester is a different journey, each semester is a different adventure. So I'm ready to endeavor on this new adventure with them. I didn't tell y'all, but I went in with the goof proof brow pencil, and I'm the shade 5. I totally forget what 5 is. I don't know if it's warm deep brown, neutral deep brown, or black brown, but I'm definitely between the darker shades because it just goes. And then I use the 24-hour brow setter, and now let's find, so sorry guys, let me just move my makeup bag all the way over here. So, you're gonna hear a lot of background noise now because my mom and dad are home and they're gonna be gossiping. I'm so sorry. But, that's all about college. I just spot conceal with the shade 57 in the Fit Me. It's really light for me. Not light for me. It's really warm for me, and I don't know, I feel like I have a neutral undertone, but I genuinely can, like, concealers just don't come in neutral undertones, drugstore concealers at least, and I'm broke, I can't go be shopping for Dior and stuff. So I just go in with the Fit Me in the shade 57. It matches me when I blend it in. It just like looks a little too orange because the undertone is a little too warm for me. I didn't pick my nose before y'all come at me. I didn't. So stop. And then I just go with the beauty blender and just immediately blend that out. I used to let my concealer sit, but honestly, I don't really care. What else to chat about? Oh my gosh, let me give y'all advice about college as we're on the topic. As we're on the topic of college, let me spit some Beayana, some Yana advice, okay? Please do not take your advisors for granted. Some of the advisors at my school, well, I've never talked to them, but I've heard horror stories about, like, my nose is so itchy, guys, I'm so sorry. I've heard, like, horror stories about advisors at other colleges about how they're so mean and stuff, or, like, because you get assigned a advisor based off the initial of your last name, based off the first letter. So I'm F, so I'm grouped with like all the kids with the last names from A to F, right? So you'll get paired, but don't be afraid to reach out to other counselors or advisors. Yes, they're probably going to have to like tell your advisor specifically that you reached out to them. I don't know the confidentiality. I don't know. Did I say that word right? I don't know. I don't know about the logistics of that, but all I know is do not take them for granted. They literally, their job, they get paid to help you. They literally cannot not help you because that's literally what they're paid to do. That is their job. They get paid to advise you. They get paid to help you. They get paid to do everything. Do not take them for granted. They are literally just giving you a service. And they're going to do it well if they want to get paid well. So find your advisor. Find the advisor that works for you and do not take them for granted. They will literally help you through everything. And the first like month and a half of school, I was afraid because I never really talked to my advisor in high school. The only time I would talk to my advisor was when they were a guidance counselor back in middle school, and only because me and her had that type of relationship where I could talk to her about any and everything, and I know it wouldn't be tossed around to every single teacher. So I just went in with Maybelline Fit Me in 45 and the high points of my face, and I let this sit though while I go in with my blush and my contour. My contour is the Black Radiance True Complexion Concealer. Yeah, I love this thing. I think I get the darkest shade, if not the darkest shade, second to darkest. Back to what I was saying, that was the only time I ever talked to an advisor. So I'm going into college basically blind. I only talked to my advisor like twice when we were talking about what school I was going to, because I got into a good amount of schools, and that was pretty much it. I didn't talk to them about anything else. So I walked into college thinking I could do the same thing, but I would literally be struggling with the tiniest thing, and teachers would be like, you gotta talk to your advisor. So I had to build up the courage, and I'm glad I did. So don't take them for granted. Also, oh my God, guys, when somebody tells you do not miss class, do not skip class, do not skip class, do not skip class, do not skip class. I'm gonna say it one more time. Do not skip class. Me personally, there was one class called Curry Launch, which is like a wellness class, and I literally didn't show up to it because it was a wellness class, and I thought personally, mentally, I was doing great. Physically, I was doing great. Academically, I was doing okay. I was doing what I expected I would be doing. So I didn't show up, and literally that class was like 75% attendance. Yeah, they assigned you work, and I did the work, and I would get good grades in the work. But if you didn't show up to class, you basically have a 50 for the day. And I didn't know that until the end, and I literally almost failed that class because I thought I didn't have to show up. Show up to your classes. Also, college, like, when a teacher in high school tells you that college moves at a faster pace than high school, they do. Some of the things that they talk about, they're like, oh my God, like, they won't turn a slide back for you. Da, 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 da. They will. They're in my psych class, if a girl asked or a guy asked if he could go back to the last slide, he would. And he would add some extra points there too. So like, it wouldn't be just us going back to the slide. We get more insight. So like, some of the things that high school teachers say about college professors isn't true. College professors are literally the chillest people ever. Unless you're stuck with like an actual strictie, like, yeah, I understand that. But they were right about one thing. They move at such a quick pace. So me personally, on the first day of my cycle, I can't move. I can't breathe. I can't do anything. I genuinely, is that the lighting or is that actually what it looks like? I don't know. Genuinely for me, I can't do anything. I can't move. Breathing's hard. I feel like I'm gonna vomit. Standing up is hard. So I wouldn't go to class on my first day of my cycle. I would stay in. And then I would have when was this? For my reading, writing, research class, I have that class twice a week, and I missed one day that week, and I went the next time I had that class, and I was genuinely so confused as to what we were doing, and I missed one class. If you don't want to be confused, if you don't want to be lost, if you don't want to be behind, go to your classes. I forgot. forgot to add it. I just added where you would normally put contour, but I also added in the like outer corners of my eyes as eyeshadow, and it's really pretty. And I just use this brush. I don't know. I think I got it from Amazon, and it's the Cintas brushes. I will look it up. I promise, and it'll be on the screen. But then for the smaller points, I use these Kala brushes. I'll also put these on the screen. I don't know. But I think that's all I have academically. Please talk. Schedule a time to study. I'm not telling you need to study in your room every night, because honestly, especially first semester, a lot of kids think that they need to stay in their room and study and study and study and study and study and study and study. No, you don't. If you schedule out, hear me out. If you schedule out an hour, 2 hours every day, 5 days a week, 4 days a week, if you want to cancel out Friday, and just study and like not even homework, like study, so you can keep up with what you're doing. If you schedule an hour or two just to study every day, I promise you, life is gonna be simple. Life is gonna be easy. You're gonna be able to do all the fun things in high school. I mean, high school, in college. If you genuinely, I really wish I took this seriously. But at the end of my semester, the beginning of my semester, I took this seriously. An hour or two a day, I would lock myself up in my old room and I would study. I would be in there for like 3.5-4 hours, and probably you guys are probably like, oh my god, that's such a long time. It honestly goes by fast. Like 2 hours I'd spend on homework, and I'd make sure to get those done, and then I would go on like a Quizlet, or like if my teacher provided like study things, I would spend another hour or two doing, like I would spend another hour or two taking my time and studying on those Quizlets and things. And my grades were amazing, but I took that a little bit for granted at the end. But now I know what works for me, so I'm definitely gonna take it so much seriously this semester. I use the e.l.f. putty blush in the shade Caribbean. And I just use another beauty blender. Yeah, but literally, don't study in your room. If you can study in your room, I literally envy you. But I personally can't. I need to study somewhere else. So find a place on campus that works for you. The library was my place, or there is a thing in the student center on the second floor called Quiet Study Lounge, and you literally could not be loud there. Like, there would be people in the next office, and if you were loud, they would come in and be like, shh. And I liked studying there a lot more, because downstairs is where like the food was, and personally, food is my brain fuel. If I'm hungry, I can't study. If I'm hungry, I can't do literally anything, so I need to eat. And it was right downstairs, so I would get myself like a bowl of, like, I wouldn't eat, I would get myself like a bowl of fruit. I would get myself like a drink, even. Like, I'm telling you, I can't work on an empty stomach. Like, even a drink by me will help me study. And yeah, so those are my tips. Schedule out time every day to study. Find a place where you can study. Go to your classes and don't take your advisors for granted. Now, let's talk about the social life of college. Let's just say every weekend I was outside. Not every weekend, because there was weekends I would come home. So then I'm just going to explain my next couple of steps, because I'm just going to be talking about the social life. So I take this Sephora brush. This is the Crease 24 brush, but I use it as a concealer brush and this beauty blender to blend it out. And then I go in with this other Sephora brush. I want to say it says Crease F11. Don't worry, like I said, I'll put them up on the screen. And this is my powder brush, and I use the Maybelline Fit Me Loose Setting Powder in the shade 30. So I live really, really close to my school. I live 20 minutes if you take the highway, and I live 45 minutes if you take the local route. So I am not far from school at all. So I'd come home some weekends and go to church, or I'd come home some weekends just to like get a change of scenery, because in the middle of the year I wasn't doing the best. Sorry, I always focus when I do my concealer. I would be home a lot, but the weekends I wasn't home, I was out, bro. Was I out doing stupid stuff? Not all the time, no. I was not out doing stupid stuff all the time. Actually, I would be the least stupid one most of the time. And now that I think about it, like, most of the time, I'd be the least stupid one there. I was, like, the mom of the group, if you want to say that. But I took weekends to just be a college kid, because during the week, you're super stressed about literally everything in the sun. You're stressed about school. If you're an athlete, you're stressed about your sports. If you're an athlete, you're stressed about your sports. If you're in a club, you're stressed about your club. Like, during the week, I was so stressed about grades, and I was stressed about dance because I had dance 3 times a week. I was stressed. And then on top of that, I also had choir during the week. I had dance rehearsal for church during the week. Like, I was busy during the week, so I took the weekends and allowed myself to be 17 and 18 years old, because I was 17 going into college. I was young and going into college. I don't want to hear nothing. I don't want to hear nobody's mouth talking about, oh my god, you were so young in college. I get it. Let's move on. But I took the weekends off. Like, I literally treated school like a job. During the week, I was stressed. Da, 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 da. But the weekend was mine to settle down and do teenage stuff. Most of the time, we wouldn't be even outside. But, like, another tip, bro. Genuinely, take some time to be a teenager. Everybody's like, oh, I'm in college now. I have to be so mature. I have to do this. I have to do that. You really don't. Because, especially for us freshmen, we act like we literally have to act 20 and 30 in college. You literally don't. And I say this wholeheartedly, bro. Like, you enter college as a teenager. What makes you think you gotta act 30 and 40 as soon as you set foot onto that campus? And another thing is, we wanna act so grown. We wanna act like, and then we talk mess about, like, the freshmen that act like high schoolers. We were in high school, like, less than a couple months ago. Like, 4 or 5 months ago, we were literally in high school. So I don't really know what you're on about. But me personally, I would never come at somebody for that, because we were in high school for 4 years of our life, and we just set foot onto a college campus. Of course we're not gonna know how to act like high schoolers. I mean, of course we're not gonna know how to act like college students. We are new to this. We're not true to this. So, like, I feel like hating on others because they act like high schoolers is crazy. My thing was, though, I just didn't like the drama. We treated drama like high school. And like I said, I know I can't hate because we just got out of high school. But drama was spread like wildfire. And my campus is not that big, but it's genuinely not that small, too, for you to be knowing everybody's business. And I'm telling you, you would know everybody's business. I was sick to my stomach. Like, why do I know all of this? But back to my original point. You have so much time ahead of you to treat college however you want to treat it. But you are a freshman. I'm not saying go out and do all the hard drugs and drink all the hard liquor that you see. I'm not telling you to do all the stupid stuff. But if there's a party that you want to go to it. If there's a concert you want to go to it. If there's something that you and your friends want to try, like a new restaurant, a new club, a new indoor trampoline park, whatever it is, go do it. Don't say, oh, I gotta do this, oh, I gotta do that. There's a Saturday morning and a Sunday morning for a reason. I'm not saying don't focus on school. That's not what I'm saying. But I'm saying work-life balance. Do your work that Saturday morning. Do your work that Friday morning after class, that Friday afternoon after class. So Friday night, you can go try that new restaurant. So Saturday night, you can go see a movie or whatever. Like, don't make college feel like a 24-hour shift. You are a teenager, and I'm so glad I allowed myself to do that, and I'm definitely going to prioritize that too, because at the beginning I didn't do that. I stayed in my room on weekends, I went home on weekends, and I treated college like it was a full-time job. And mentally, I was struggling mentally, because I'm going from being a high schooler who had this amazing work-life balance, who allowed herself to go out sometimes, and then the summer where I was out all the time, but I was still like working and making money, to a college student who stayed stagnant and didn't grow and didn't make friends and didn't do nothing. I didn't make mistakes so I can learn from them. I literally just stayed away from them. Like, what was I doing, genuinely? And I guess mentally I wasn't allowing myself to be 17 years old. I was genuinely 17. I wasn't allowing myself to be 17, and it was my last couple of months of being 17. I wasn't allowing myself to do that. And then as soon as I made deeper connections with the people that I'm friends with, they started inviting me to things and stuff like that. And I, instead of being like, no, I'm going home, I'd call my parents and be like, oh, I'm not going home this weekend. And I prioritized being able to be a teenager. And it was the best thing for me, genuinely. Like, that is one thing I'm definitely going to bring into every single semester. Friday nights, Saturdays, and Saturday nights are my nights to just go see a movie, go to a club, go to a party, go upstairs into my friend Abby's room and play card games, or have her do our nails. Like, just be a teenage girl. Just be a teenager. Like, that's literally it. But also, don't be that teenager. So I'm gonna, let me get back into this, and then I'll tell you more. I'm gonna use this Sephora palette, and I'm gonna go in with this gold shade that I hit pan on as my highlighter, and I'm gonna use this fan brush, the same Cintas pack. So back to what I was saying, don't be that teenager, okay? Don't be that teenager who gets, why do I keep saying teenager? College kid. Don't be that college kid. Don't be that college kid who literally is sloppy drunk every weekend. Can't remember their weekends. Sleeps around with so many different guys. And I'm not saying that because, oh, that's dirty. Oh, you're sloppy drunk every week. I'm not doing that to judge you. I'm doing that because it's not a good look for you. Personally, I don't really judge people on what they do when it comes to partying and boys, because we all got our differences when it comes to that, bro. I can't be judging, because y'all hear some of the stories that I used to endeavor in. Y'all used to hear the things that I used to endeavor in before I genuinely stopped, before I settled down. Y'all would judge me too. You'd be like, yo, Beyonce, what the hell? Okay, so I genuinely can't judge. But it's just not a good look. Your reputation is going to precede you, and that's all everybody is going to know you as. Whether it's a good thing or a bad thing, if you don't want to be known as the sloppy drunk, but you are that literally every weekend, that is what you're going to be known as, and you can't help it. You can't help it. Once you become the sloppy drunk, that's all everyone's going to know you as, and it's going to be very, very difficult to not be known as that. Trust me, when I say very difficult, I mean very difficult. If you don't want to be known as the girl who sleeps around, which honestly, go you. If you're not getting any diseases from it, I mean, I pray for you. That's literally all I can say. I pray for you. Like, if you're not getting any diseases, if nothing bad is happening to you, all I can say is I'm praying for you, girl. Like, but if you don't want to be known as the girl who sleeps around, don't do it. And you're probably like, oh, well, it always depends on the people that I tell. Yeah, you could be telling people that you trust. And wholeheartedly, I tell my friends everything. And I know that they're not going to tell the next person. Unless, like, I tell the next person and they want to add, like, a couple opinions. I know for a fact my friends aren't going to open their mouth and tell other people. But you don't know what that other person is telling people. You don't know if they're opening their mouths and they're telling each and every single person. And like I said, on my campus, drama spreads like a wildfire. So, you can tell somebody, and somebody else could be overhearing that conversation, and now it's the whole talk of their friend group, and somebody heard their friend group talking about it. So now, you know? But if you don't want that type of reputation, do not be that person. Because for me personally, I knew I didn't want to be known as the sloppy drunk. I didn't want to be known as the girl who slept around. Because I didn't want to be known as anything negative, especially being on the dance team. If I had anything like that tied to my name, it was done. It was done. I couldn't do it. It was done. Couldn't do it. So, I took matters into my own hands. You know, and if you do want to do whatever that, if you do want to sleep around and be a sloppy drunk, do that discreetly. Okay, keep that between you and people that you trust, okay? I just did a couple beauty marks. I don't know. Y'all can see. I love beauty marks, guys. Something about them. I just love them. And I added a lot to my face. I'm not gonna sit here and lie. I add a lot. But I just used the LA Colors Intense Lining Liquid Eyeliner. Yeah. Like, I can't say this enough. If you don't want to have a bad reputation, make sure that you either do the things that you want to do discreetly or don't do them at all. Like, for example, let's say if I wanted to drink and I wanted to get drunk, I would make sure that I do it once every month. If I wanted to, I'd make sure to do it once every month. But I'm not gonna do it every weekend. I'm not gonna do it at every party. Like, it's either, and like, I know people who pre-gamed and then they would drink a little bit of water so that they weren't sloppy at the party. Do that. Or they would do it after parties as like a way to end the night off. Do that. But if you don't want a bad reputation, please. We're reaching the last steps of my makeup. I used 3 Essence mascaras. This one is the Curl and Volume. This one is the Curl. And this one is the Waterproof Mascara. And I use it in that same order. But I don't bring it all the way up here. I only do the ends of my eyelashes. Yo, my face has been itching me this entire time. Okay. But, yes, when it comes to social life, so that's the one thing. Do not do, like, let yourself be a teenager. Let yourself enjoy college. This is your first semester. This is your first year. Do not just sit in your room all the time. Because you're genuine. Like, if you are an introvert and you do like being alone, do not listen to what I said. But if you're like me, I'm like an introverted extrovert. Like, I need time to myself. Or I'm gonna go crazy, but I also like being out with friends. So if you're like me, I say take my advice a little bit more seriously. But yes, so just allow yourself, give yourself a day or two out of the 7-day week where you allow yourself to just be a teenager and go out and do stuff. But I'm not just saying party. Like, if there's a movie that you wanna see, go see it. If there's a new restaurant you wanna try out, go try it out. Like, don't just be like, oh, I can't leave campus, I can't do that. No, like, don't block yourself from being able to experience things, because college is the time to experience. Because once you're out of college, like, it's real, like, life is real. So do everything now, so you know. And also, don't create a reputation for yourself that you don't want, like, you wouldn't want for yourself. Or what I would say is, Would I want my daughter to be known for this? Would I want my son to be known for this if they're in college? And if it's a no, then I shouldn't be doing this. Because, like, imagine this gets back to my mom and dad, and they hear all the stuff that I do. Like, first off, I probably wouldn't be able to live on campus this semester. And second of all, they'd be genuinely, thoroughly disappointed in me. And I do not want that. But socially, find your people. And don't expect to find your people within the first week. I expected that my friend group, I had to find them within the first week of college. And if I didn't, I was a loser. And I did have a friend group the first week of college. But I'm not... I'm maybe friends with, like, 4 people from that friend group now. And it was a pretty hefty friend group. I have a big friend group now, but it took a while. So, yes, you want to find your main 1 or 2 people your first 2 weeks of college. You do want to find those main 2 people that you know you won't stop talking to. You know that will be by your side for the rest of the semester. But if you want a friend group, do not expect it until, like, I'm going to be honest with you, after the first month. I have barely have any of the setting spray left, so I literally might... You hear it? You hear how there's nothing coming out? I'm gonna end it all, bro. So I guess another no setting spray look. It's okay. Okay. But yeah, I like the friend group that I have, and I love my friend group so much. We were solid until the beginning of October, and I moved in August 24th. So just think about it that way. Don't expect to find your people that quickly, because one thing about us freshmen is we're all just trying to find friends so we don't look lonely. We don't care if we build genuine connections with these people, and that's something that I had to realize and pick up on. So yeah, some of your friendships at the beginning can be genuine. I'll say that right now. Like, a couple of my friends at the beginning of the year were genuine friends that I still am friends with now. But a friend group is a lot. It's a lot to handle. It's a lot to take care of, because there's a lot of people. And you guys are going to be hanging out in one place with a lot of people. So you got to think about it. Do I think I could be myself with these people 24/7? Do you think I could tell these people everything? Do you think, yeah, you guys start asking yourself those questions. And I'm going to be honest with you. At the beginning of the school year, most of those answers are going to be no. No, you can't be yourself around these people. No, you're not going to want to hang out with these people all the time. And the only reason why you are is because you don't want to look alone. You gotta think about it this way. Would you be friends with these people all 4 years of high school? If they went to your high school, would you be friends with these people? And if your answer is no, don't be friends with them now. And so many people are like, oh, well, I've changed. Like, I tolerate so much more. I'm different now. Yeah, but, like, me personally, back in high school, I couldn't do big friend groups. I couldn't do them. The majority friends I would have are like 7 or 8. And now I have like 10, 11 friends, which is not so much more, but like, there's so many people that I know that would have like maybe 3 friends in high school. And they come into college expecting 7 or 8. Nah. I just used the Maybelline Define Ally Brownish Black Eyeliner, but I use it as a lip pencil. And now I'm going to go in with the NYX Butter Gloss and Lava Cake all over my lips. Yeah. That's what you got to ask yourself. That's what I asked myself. I asked myself, would you be friends with these people in high school? Would you be friends with these people at Foxborough Regional Charter School? Would you bring these people to Foxborough Regional Charter School events? Like, would I invite them to soccer games? Would I invite them to basketball games? Would I invite them to my track meets, dances? And if my answer was no, I'd start distancing myself. Because I'm so bad at, like, cutting off people just off rip, like, ripping off the mandate. I'm so bad at that. But I would distance myself. There's somebody that I distance myself from, not because I wouldn't bring them to my school or things. Our schedules just don't add up. I still love her dearly. And I just went with Butter Gloss in the shade Brownie Drip. And lastly, I'm going to go in with the Fenty Lip Gloss and Fussy. I love her so much. We didn't stop talking because of nothing she did. Or because I didn't feel like I'd be able to bring her to like my schools and stuff. It was genuinely because of scheduling. But you really just got to think about it. You really got to think about it like that. You really got to think about it like that. If you don't think that you would be friends with those people all 4 years of high school, newsflash, maybe those aren't the people for you. And that is a hard pill to swallow. But socially, I'm going to reiterate what I said socially because it's very important. If you don't want to be known for something, do not make that your reputation. Because your reputation precedes you. Allow yourself to be a kid. Allow yourself to be a teenager. Because these are the last years you're going to be a teenager. Give yourself 2-3 days out of the week to do crazy things or experience new things. Enjoy your alone time. And don't expect to meet the people that you're going to spend the entire 4 years of college with your first semester of college. And lastly, think about it. Would you be friends with these people all 4 years of high school? 3 years of high school, 2 years of high school, your last year of high school, any year of high school, all of them, one of them, would you be friends with these people? And if your answer is no, maybe you shouldn't be friends with them. One more thing, do not think your first hookup in college is going to be who you end up with. Please do not do that. Do not, like, hookups are very normal in college. I've seen so many. Do not expect the first person you hook up with or sleep with is going to be the love of your life or your husband or your boyfriend. Don't. Because you probably thought the hookup meant something, but I'm telling you, especially if they're a guy, they just did it for fun. They did it for a bet. They did it for money. They did it because they wanted some, you know what. They didn't do it because they liked you. And if they did, they wouldn't have done it that quickly. They wouldn't have done it the first night if they really truly wanted something from you that wasn't just that. They would actually wait. They would get to know you. They would spend quality time with you, understand who you are. So just take that with a grain of salt. Just take that with a grain of salt. But anyways, that is the end of this. I don't know if I call it a makeup routine. I guess I'm just gonna call it a college advice chit chat. Get ready with me, I guess. That was the end of that. I hope you guys enjoyed it. I definitely like this a lot better than my last one, so hopefully this touches the screens. Make sure you like, comment, subscribe, and share the video. I hope you guys take my advice very, very, very seriously, or not. That's up to you. But yeah, just make sure you tag along for other videos. Bye.